I am Dr. Sirish Nelivegi. I am a consultant ophthalmic surgeon and I am the director of Nelivegi Eye Hospital, which is situated at Belandur on the Outer Ring Road at Bangalore. Macular degeneration is basically an age-related change. Macula is the most sensitive spot on the eye. So this is the model of the eyeball. This is the back of the eye and this is the front of the eye. At the back of the eye, there is a layer called as retina. And the retina is the most sensitive layer of the eye, which receives the lights and then takes this light impulses and then conducts it through the optic nerve to the brain. Now, in the retina, there is one specific spot more or less at this area, which is called as macula. In macula, over a period of time, sometimes there can be changes which happen due to old age. This happens again because of some abnormal deposits happening in that area or some blood vessel leaks which are happening in that area. And this situation can cause drop in the vision or distortion in the vision or any kind of alterations in the vision. This situation, we call it as age-related macular degeneration. AMD can certainly cause blindness, and in fact, AMD is the second largest cause of irreversible blindness in people all over the world. The commonest cause of irreversible blindness is glaucoma, and AMD comes second. AMD blindness can depend upon whether the AMD has been a dry type or a wet type. If it is a wet type, the blindness can happen very rapidly and in a very, very high speed. And here, the treatment can be pretty challenging. In the dry type, here also there can be blindness, but then the blindness happens over a period of many, many years or maybe even decades. But the peculiar thing about AMD is, AMD involves macula, which is the most sensitive area of the retina and which is responsible for our straight ahead vision. Though the patient will have blindness, it may not be complete blindness or 100% blindness that you would think of. Since only the central part of the retina is involved and the peripheral retina is normal more or less, the peripheral vision of a person will be more or less retained. This is to say, when a patient sees straight ahead, he may not be able to get a very clear view, whereas when he is looking straight ahead, and then he's seeing the field of vision through his periphery, he may be able to see that more or less normally. So in the wet type of AMD, usually there are treatments which are available in the form of vascular endothelial growth factors or injections which are given to the eye, which can control the amount of leak and the rapid deterioration that's happening. Whereas in the dry type, we give antioxidants in the form of tablets, but then controlling a dry type is usually a very difficult task. But now, though there is treatment for the wet type of age-related degeneration, the deterioration is so rapid that most of the times, before we control it, the patient would have lost his central vision irreversibly. Once the scarring happens in the retina, then we cannot retrieve the vision and the patient may be centrally blind forever. The symptoms of the AMD or the age-related macular degeneration will depend upon the type of the AMD. Broadly speaking, there are two varieties of age-related macular degeneration. One is called as the wet type and another is called as the dry type. Usually the dry type is less symptomatic, or rather it's a very slowly progressive condition. And the wet type is a very rapidly progressive condition. So usually it is difficult for the patient to become symptomatic or to complain about the AMD when he has a dry type of AMD. Once the dry type of AMD advances to a certain level, in such situations, the patient can complain of a vague blurring of vision, or it can also be a distortion in the vision or distortion in the lines that the patient is seeing. Or very rarely, it can be a slight shadowing of the vision which can happen. In the wet kind of AMD, the situation is far worse. The deterioration of vision is far, far rapid. The patient can progress from a clear vision to a blurred vision in a matter of days to weeks or even months. Here, the patient will have no doubt that his vision is going down. It will be so rapid that it becomes very obvious to the patient that the vision is going down.